Hi friends, thank you so much for watching my video on how to balance a scooter. And this one, I'll be talking more on the features. Now, has it happened ever with you that you are riding a scooter and suddenly there's some distraction and you know where the brake is, but yet you don't apply brake, you rather keep your feet down and you stop the scooter? Or has it ever happened that you want to turn left and you just miss out on giving the indication, a left indication, or if you want to turn right, a right indication? So let's find out the best way to use these features, the way I have learnt it. I'm just trying to pass it on to you. So on the right hand side, you have the start key, the ignition key, which you have to push and turn it on. So once the key is on, the headlight of the scooter flashes. The headlight of the scooter gets automatically on. So on the right hand side, you have this self-start button which you can use with your thumb. So whenever you're using this, when you start the scooter, first you have to press brake and then only start the scooter. So on your left hand side you have a brake and the scooter starts. On the left you have brake. Now most of the time it happens, what I was telling you, that you are riding a scooter, you know that on the left and the right your hand you have a brake. You always have your fingers also on the brake. But then when the distraction comes, we mostly are clueless of using, we get into panic and we don't use brake most of the time. We rather stop the scooter by our feet. So you have to practice, just to apply brake. So what you can do is you have to start the vehicle, stop it and apply brake. On the left hand side you have this left and right indicator. It goes left. Again it comes into the center. You have to just press it to stop it. If you have to go right, you have to press right, move it towards the right, and again you have to press in the center, it stops. So once you complete your left, taking left or taking right, you can just press the center button and stop the indicator. Just below the indicator you have horn. I won't recommend using horn much, yet in case of emergency you can use this. It's on the left thumb.
Thank you for watching.
These are the rear view mirrors which help us to see the vehicles which are coming behind us when we are riding, so that we can drive safely. Now, most of the time we are aware of the features of the scooter. We know that left hand side brake is there, there are rear view mirrors to see the vehicle, then there is the left right indicator. But when it comes to using the these features, as we are new to the scooter, we often get fumbled while using the features of the scooter. So I would advise that along with the practice of riding a scooter, of balancing a scooter, also put in some time to practice the application of brake, the usage of left and right indicator, the usage of rear view mirror, and make it a point that you are using it deliberately. Like, use brake while you are riding. Though there is no distraction, just make use of brake so that your brain gets a message that okay, on the left hand side there is a brake and you can use it when there is a distraction or when there is a problem or when you want to stop a vehicle. So make your brain aware of these features so you can use it properly, or you can use it flawlessly or fluently when you are riding. But this needs practice. So as you practice,